Hey guys, it's Hodgepodge here, and today we are going to be doing a review of the Schleich 2020 Baryonyx figure. Now, Baryonyx was a theropod from the Cretaceous period, the early Cretaceous to be more specific, of the Spinosauridae family, and it is one of my personal favourite dinosaurs, not just because it's from England. It was discovered in the Wessex Formation, where it lived alongside Iguanodon, Hypsilophodon, Neovenator, and Polacanthus, just to name a few. Alright, so let's have a look at this figure. Now, my good friend here on YouTube, the Ark Minister, who runs the Great Primeval Show YouTube channel, requested me to review this model, and I'm more than happy to oblige. There will be a link to his awesome channel in the description of this video, and I've been in a few of his videos so far, so feel free to check them out, and all of his videos. Okay, now onto the actual model. Now, considering that this is Schleich and their less than stellar reputation amongst the dinosaur model community, this is an incredibly pleasant surprise. This is leaps and bounds ahead of their other offerings, not just from last year, but just in general. It's such a nice outlier amongst a pretty unimpressive lot, let's be honest. This Baryonyx, though, is a wonderful model. Now, starting off with the head, you can see straight away that there is an impressive amount of scale detail going on. There is unfortunately a few seams going on here at the back of the neck, the back of the head. But they're pretty hard to spot from a distance, because like if I move it back there, you can just barely make it out. As for the actual head itself, this is a really, really good Baryonyx head sculpt. It's got the characteristic crest on the top of the head. The eyes are like a really striking pink color, which I've never seen before, which is cool. The teeth, they are very blunt, but it's a children's toy at the end of the day, so they do need to have safety precautions. But honestly, they're pretty good, considering that they've had to be dulled down so much. There is very minimal shrink wrapping. You can just barely make out the antorbital fenestra and the orbit there, but it's really hard to notice. So I think they've done a good job there. And you can just barely make out the nostrils just above my thumbnail there. And you can see they've got the notch, the premaxillary notch there, which is accurate to the skull. And it does have an articulated jaw, and this is a really good one. It's not fiddly, it's not overly stiff or anything, and it stays in place. Now, I personally prefer to have mine open because, unfortunately on mine, you'll see underneath, when you close the jaw, you can see some of the pink paint from the interior of the mouth is still visible on the outside, which is unfortunate. This could just be on mine. I hope it's not prevalent amongst all of them, but that is something to note. The interior of the mouth, the tongue is a different colour, which is a really nice attention to detail, and you can just about make out, unfortunately the roof of the mouth isn't sculpted, it is just smooth. There we go, that's a better view. You can see, and the back of the mouth, it doesn't really have like a clear throat, but that's honestly alright. Now, one of the biggest, in fact, the biggest criticism I have of this model is the proportions. The body proportions of this Baryonyx are quite off. The head is too big, the tail is a bit too short, and the feet are huge. Now, a nice place where this isn't the case is with the forelimbs. The arms are pretty much, as far as I can tell, perfect. They're not pronated, which is good, and they've got the characteristic heavy claw. The first claw is much bigger than the other two on the fingers, which is where Baryonyx gets its name. It means heavy claw, and that's just really, they look really natural. They look relaxed. They're not all over the place. I think it's really good. They look well muscled as well. You can see here, we can see the skin folding as it goes from the shoulder to the arm. That's really nice. Then we go to the legs. The legs are also really well muscled. You can see that scale detail is really good. Now, unfortunately, the feet are really big on this model, which does help for it to stand, but yeah, they are quite huge. The middle toe should be a little bit longer than the other two, because that's this is a common mistake on a lot of theropod models, where they'll make all three of the walking toes the same size, but the middle toe should be a bit longer, because that's the one that bore most of the weight of the animal. The hallucs, which is the dew claw here, they might be a little bit too big and maybe a little bit too far down, but honestly, it's pretty good. It really is pretty good. And the tail here, it might be a little bit too curvy, and it might be a little bit too short, but you do see that really cool stripe going down the spine. And if you look very closely, you can see that this spine is actually bumpy. There's this ridge going down to almost the tip of the tail. The tip of the tail is pretty smooth, but yeah, these osteoderms going down the spine is a really cool detail, as well as there's these just barely visible smaller ones along the flanks as well, which is a really nice detail. And when we look at this side, we can see it's almost got a different expression to the other. It's it almost looks like this is a more angry or intimidating expression. So you can get some interesting poses or dioramas with this. It's got a really cool pose, even though the tail is probably a bit too curved for Baryonyx. But overall, it's really cool. This is a solid, solid model. It's pretty accurate, well sculpted. Now the paint scheme, you may notice, bears a striking resemblance to the Jurassic World Suchomimus. And yeah, you could say it's kind of lazy on Schleich's part for basically just copying that color scheme, but this is far from the first time a model has copied the color scheme of another form of media for an animal. So I let it slide. I like how it looks. Now in terms of the size, you're looking at around, I think that's about 24 centimeters, maybe a bit longer. In terms of the height, that's looking about 11 centimeters, almost on the dot, just shy. And something else I thought would be fun to do is a comparison with other models. So what I've got here are some other models of dinosaurs found in the Wessex Formation that lived alongside Baryonyx. So here we have the tiny little Collecte Hypsilophodon diorama. And believe it or not, this is actually pretty much to scale as well as the Baryonyx. And another Collecte model from the Wessex Formation is the Deluxe Iguanodon. And all three of these scale up really nicely. So you've got a really cool diorama here of the Wessex Formation. So in conclusion, this is a solid, solid Baryonyx model. It's not perfect, but considering this is Schleich we're talking about, this is fantastic. This really is one of the best models they have ever made, in my opinion. And I highly, highly recommend picking this up. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye now.